Late today, ABC News got exclusive access inside the house where baby Lisa Irwin went missing, including the nursery, filled with tiny shoes, tiny clothes, tiny foot and hand prints.
This is the crib where at roughly 10:30 on Monday night, Lisa's mother says she put her daughter down to sleep, and that, she says, is the last time she saw her.
After becoming the anguished public voice of this crisis,
just want our baby back. Please, bring her home.
Deborah Bradley told us today that just hours after her daughter was reported missing Tuesday morning, Kansas City police turned on her.
Did they accuse you directly?
Oh, yeah.
What'd they say?
You killed her. You killed her. You know where she's at. Give everybody else closure. You know you did it. And I kept saying, no, that's not possible. No.
She says she volunteered to take a polygraph, which police told her she failed.
Did you have anything to do with her disappearance?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
In a separate room, detectives were also questioning the baby's father.
And all this time where you have police officers storming into the room and saying to you, she did it. Did you have a nanosecond of doubt at any point?
No, there's never any doubt in my mind.
The parents insist they are not angry with police. Our interview ended with a pledge to continue working with both investigators and the media.
I'm gonna find baby Lisa.
Their relationship with investigators may be fraying, but their relationship with one another,
I'm sorry,
is showing no cracks at all. Dan Harris, ABC News, Kansas City.